At the start of the game, the protagonist Jack is a passenger on an airliner which goes down in the Atlantic Ocean in 1960, sometime after ordered society in Rapture has collapsed. After surfacing, Jack finds himself the only survivor of the crash, and swims to a nearby towering lighthouse on an island. He finds there a bathysphere which descends him into the ocean's abyss and the entrance to the underwater city of Rapture. An Irishman, Atlas, assists Jack in making his way to safety via the service radio found in the submarine vessel. Andrew Ryan, believing Jack to be an agent of a surface nation, uses Rapture's automated systems and his pheromone-controlled splicers against him. Atlas tells Jack that the only way he can survive is to use the abilities granted by plasmids, and that he must kill the little sisters accompanied by their hulking, armored protectors, the Big Daddies, to extract their atom. Inadvertently crossing paths with Jack, Dr. Tenenbaum urges him to save the little sisters instead, giving him a plasmid that will safely kill the embedded sea slugs in each little sister, reverting them to normal girls. Atlas says his wife and child have been hiding on a submarine and directs Jack towards it. Just as Jack and Atlas reach the bay where it is located, Ryan has it destroyed. An enraged Atlas guides Jack on a mission to kill Ryan. Eventually, Jack confronts Ryan in his office, where the latter is casually playing golf. Ryan reveals a truth that he has pieced together. Jack was actually born in Rapture a mere 4 years ago, genetically modified to mature rapidly. He is Ryan's illegitimate son by an affair with Jasmine Jolene, an exotic dancer. Ryan further reveals that, after purchasing Jack's embryo, Frank Fontaine designed him to obey orders that are preceded or followed by the specific phrase, "Would you kindly?" Jack was then sent to the surface when the Rapture Civil War started to put him beyond Ryan's reach. When the conflict between Fontaine and Ryan reached a stalemate, Jack was sent instructions to board a flight with a package and to use its contents, a revolver, to hijack and crash the plane near the lighthouse, enabling him to return to Rapture as a tool of Fontaine. Because Jack was Ryan's son, he could freely use Rapture's bathysphere network, which had been locked out to everyone except those within Ryan's genetic ballpark. Finally, Ryan has Jack kill him, wanting to die on his own terms. With Ryan's death, Jack realizes too late that Atlas has also been using the trigger phrase to control him. Atlas reveals himself to be Frank Fontaine, who faked his death to throw Ryan off his trail and take control of the city, leaving Jack at the mercy of the reactivated security systems. Dr. Tenenbaum and her little sisters help Jack escape through the vent system, where he falls and loses consciousness. When Jack awakens, Dr. Tenenbaum has already deactivated some of his conditioned responses, such as the trigger phrase itself, and assists him in breaking the remaining ones, among them one that would have eventually stopped his heart. With the help of the little sisters, Jack is able to track down Fontaine. The mob boss, having been cornered, injects himself with vast amounts of atom and becomes an inhuman monster. Jack battles him, eventually prevailing and allowing the little sisters to subdue and extract the atom from his body, killing him. Three endings are possible depending on how the player interacted with the little sisters, all narrated by Dr. Tenenbaum. If the player rescued all of the little sisters, therefore saving their lives, the ending shows five little sisters returning to the surface with Jack and living full lives under his care, including their graduation from college, getting married, and having children. It ends on a heartwarming tone, with an elderly Jack surrounded on his deathbed by all five of the adult little sisters.